Blog Talk Radio.
Okay, okay, okay.
DJ
so the buzzer, she said, okay. So what she wearing? Chanel and Dolce. How she rolling? Beat up like OJ. Skirt, skirt on the skirt on the skirt. How much time do you got for a wrist? I need action, I'm relaxing. And the nose nasty, so take it by the legs on his like a fracture. Right left, hit her with that right left.
Hey, hey, hey. Tunnel vision in the house. This, I'm
hey,
this
hey.
Vicky.
And it's DJ Dika. What's up? What's up?
Yeah.
Well, hey, listen.
You know what? Well, you know what? I just wanted to make a comment. So, first of all, you all, please forgive me for my voice. I'm hoarse. I've been doing a lot, so I'm a little hoarse. But anyway, pushing it right on through. That song is really starting to rub on me. Like, I'm really starting to feel that song because I feel like a lot of times we be going through life, and sometimes we do have to hit it with the right, left, or hit it with the left. I mean, the right or the left. You know, like we boxing, because you have to make it through life, and sometimes you have to fight to hold your head up high, fight to get up and go to work, fight to get through bills you have to pay, fight to deal with issues of life with family or love, your close loved ones or whatever. So that song, it just hit me real hard. I'm like, that's right. It kind of gave me like some energy. I was like, okay, I can do this. Even horse and all, I can do this. So I just wanted to share that.
Well, I'm so glad that it's rubbing off on you, but I'm going to have to come with reality for you. This might be the last time we play that song. Maybe one more time, because we're working on getting another song from an independent artist. So we'll discuss
that's right.
That when we
that's right.
All
I'm
right,
just saying that just it was good for the moment. I'm telling you, for the time that we used it, and I'm just saying the benefit that I got out of it. And then I'm believing that there's some people out there that got a benefit from it too.
My bad.
So
I don't want to knock you. Right, go on. So hopefully somebody got a message like Miss Vicky got out of the song. Okay. I just, you know how we have to do back to life.
Long
back to life. Yes, it is. Back
to reality.
You know, tunnel vision wouldn't be tunnel vision if you didn't come from the right and I didn't come from the left. That's just how we do. You know what I'm saying? That's the whole
right.
point of the show. You know, we tunnel vision,
right.
But, you know, as we do on the show, you coming from one way and I'm coming from another way. But at the end of the show, we've learned that we got to see both sides of the equation. Not just Dika see her way and Vicky see her way, and that's why we're just tunnel vision. Thank you. All righty then.
Mm-hmm.
So let's move on. A lot has been going on this week. So first I want to share and talk about – hold on. Hold up. Wait a minute. That ain't what I was trying to say. What's that we used to do? Hold up. Wait a minute. Okay. Did you
that's
know,
it.
Folks – That's it. That's right. Okay, you know how we do, or did you know, Mommy? Okay, so this week we will not be doing an unsung hero, so we're going to have to research, and we'll have one for you next week. So did you know, Mommy? Oh, another thing is we're doing it in the evening. This is our first time doing
right.
the evening. You guys like the evening show because I'm kind of feeling this evening show. Long as I take
Me
my
too.
Nap, I'm straight. Long as I take my nap, I'm straight. Okay, y'all don't want me
right.
to sleep on the show. But anyway, let's get back to seriousness. Did you know, Mommy? Did you know today in history, according to the Associated Press? So remember, we got to give you facts. We got to give you sources. Okay, this ain't just Dika and Vicky running the show. No, we're giving you sources. Okay, according to the Associated Press, today is Sunday, September 8th. The 251 deaths of 2019, there are 114 days left in the year. I kind of like that. So we're going to make that part of
right.
our vision. No, we do our show. Also,
yeah.
you know, Mommy.
Because I didn't know that was how many days was left in the year. I had no idea. I wasn't even thinking about tomorrow. I wasn't even thinking about next week. I was just thinking about today. Matter of fact, I probably thought about yesterday.
And see, that's what research is all about. So you can see me and Vicky take time to do our show as we produce it, and we pick up stuff. So I found this interesting information. It's going to be part of our show now. Also, today, highlighting history, on September 8th, 1792, an early version of the Pledge of Allegiance. Oh, hear me? The Pledge of Allegiance, written by Francis Bellamy, appeared in the Youth Companion. And it did not go the way it goes today. In the Youth Companion in 1892, it went something like this: I pledge allegiance to my flag and the republic for which it stands, one nation, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now, if y'all was paying attention, that ain't how we say it today. We say I pledge allegiance to the flag. Hello, the flag. That's an interesting little thing there. We say,
yeah, I wonder who changed it.
To the flag, and I can't even remember the rest of it now. I pledge allegiance to the flag, under republic, for which it stands, one nation, indivisible. Yeah, it's really different. Okay, I'm gonna have the right.
And then the other part is that when we say the pledge of allegiance, we say one stand under God.
There we go.
Indivisible. So on here it says, I pledge allegiance to my flag and the republic. And we don't say republic. We say I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. And we do say the republic.
Yes. And to the republic.
To the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So the part that's missing is the God part, and then they change the my to the.
And the invisible part, that's kind of mixed up in there. Yeah. So
indivisible was in there, though.
Yeah, but it's still, you just said it differently. It's still different. Say it one more time.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. So that part is added as well.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord. I don't want to say it again because I'm getting confused. Oh, for which it stands, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. So indivisible is in there.
And then that United States part you said is not in there. Okay, so we see it as different. All right, next, moving on. You heard it first on Tunnel Vision. Start jumping. 1986, on September 8th, the Whippy Show began its first of 25 seasons in national syndication. Also, September 8th, 2019, is declared Grandparents' Day. On the Sunday following Labor Day, National Grandparents' Day honors the love only parents can provide. Grandparents and their grandchildren.
Wait a minute.
What?
I need to go back to the Oprah Winfrey.
Okay.
I need to say something about Oprah Winfrey. I thank God for her. I do.
Amen.
I thank God for the example that she has set for black women. And then I thank God for the example she set for women in general, because she's not a selfish person to just think about her own race. She thinks about all women across, you know, the color line. But also, I appreciate her too for the opportunities that she has given other people that are actors and people that are inspirational speakers in different fields of life. Even they have counselors like Ianla Vance Lance. how she has a show. So the different people that have shows, and so I'm saying I appreciate her for starting her network. And then on her network, I thank God for the different shows, which we're going to go into if we have time today. The different shows that she have on there are very educational. Some people may not see it that way, but if you actually come out of that tunnel vision mindset, you might actually learn something. You might actually see some things on her shows that really can help some people, because sometimes we so focused on our own lives that we don't feel like it fits in our lifestyle, or we're hiding from something. So sometimes it could be something that you can help somebody with, or you just be aware of these things that go on. So her shows touch on a lot of stuff, let me correct something. The shows that she allowed to be on her network is what I'm saying. And a lot of them are that we've been watching is Tyler Perry shows. So I just wanted to put that plug in there, since we was already talking about Oprah. I don't want to mess up how you want to do what you're presenting, DJ Deka, but I just, since you brought up Oprah, I just had to say that.
So all right, just
you
that.
Can go ahead, like and then if we have time, we'll go back to touch on some of those things that people can check out.
It's not a problem, Ms. Vicky. That's what our show is all about, tunnel vision. We want to go outside the box. Thank you. Okay, so going back to Oprah Winfrey, she, in 1986, on this day, she started her first of 25 seasons of international syndication. And with that, she no longer does the talk show. But she did. My point is, like Ms. Vicky was saying, she didn't just stop there. She was very successful with her talk show. And through her talk show, Dr. Phil got his own show because he was a guest on her show.
Yeah, she's a trailblazer. That's what she is.
Yeah.
She's
and
a
then
trailblazer.
The person that Vicky just mentioned, I can't watch her show, but that's Vicky's show. I'll let Vicky have her. I can't. She be touching on my toes.
Oh,
okay,
yeah,
anyway.
I love Lance.
Yeah, because she was a guest on her show, whatever. Okay, so Oprah Winfrey, you know, retired from her talk show, but then she took it to a whole other level and started her own network. That's what I'm talking about. Not too many people do that, okay? Or they feel like they can't do it, but Oprah Winfrey did not feel that way. You know, she took her money and she invested into her own network. And then she has brought Tyler Perry into her network, and they're doing shows together. And then the lady that we're going to talk about the show in a second, the director, the famous director that has become famous now, and I can't remember her name right now, but she's director of many movies, and she's one of the directors of Queen Sugar, and I do believe Wheeling. But anyway, you guys know who I'm talking about. I don't have information, but if I can look it up, I will. Okay, but going back to Grandparents' Day. Okay, grandparents and their grandchildren share a special bond. These huggy, caring, and patient people in the lives of children offer more than a generous dose of love. Grandparents provide an abundance of wisdom. They also offer guidance and stability. Also, moving on, did you know?
So today you saying today is Grandparents' Day?
Yes. Okay.
Okay.
So that was a did you know moment. Okay. Okay, now going back to my digital moment. Also, NFL football season, yay! Not preseason.
Yes.
The official season started today. Who are you
going
for?
Oh, man.
Okay, so to give y'all a little highlight,
what?
The Dallas Cowboys won today. They beat the Giants.
Oh, that's what's up.
Also,
oh, that's
the
what's
Rams.
Up.
Rams beat the Panthers. I'm so happy about that. But it was a close game. I was watching it, and I thought the Panthers were going to catch up, but they didn't. So it was 30-27, and the Rams won. So the Dallas Cowboys beat the Giants like they was rag dogs. And that's all I'm going to say about that one. Their score was fast. 35
Well, that's good.
Okay.
That's good. They need to play like that all season. I'm looking forward to it.
Okay. So I was a Rams fan when I was a kid, and then I went off into other things. Cause I really don't have a specific team, but I went to the Super Bowl. But I know this. I like when the LA team is there. Right now it's the Rams. So moving on, we're going to see.
I'm a Raiders fan, and I started off years ago as a Raiders fan, and then I kind of ventured off. I think that's when I got saved. I got saved, and I stopped really being into sports. But as I became a mature Christian, eventually I started getting interested in sports again. So I was just watching football, and I just liked the game because really generally I actually really love the game. Even though the Raiders haven't been in the Super Bowl, I still enjoy watching the Super Bowl. So, but I did make a choice. I believe it was 3 Super Bowls ago. I chose, right before the Super Bowl, I chose the Raiders. It was when the Raiders started doing, when their whole game switched and they started doing well. However, I am an honorary Cowboys fan because my choices was between Cowboys, Seahawks, and the Raiders. And I actually still like the Seahawks, too. So if I have my side teams, it'll be the Cowboys and the Seahawks. Seahawks always entertain me. I love watching the Seahawks game for some reason. But Raiders, I decided to go back home and be a Raiders fan. And I know they moved to Vegas now, or they're moving to Vegas, so that's fine. But I became a Raiders fan when they were still in L.A. No, they was in Oakland.
Okay.
When they was in Oakland.
Okay.
That's when I became a Raiders fan.
Since we're talking about football, we're talking about basketball when basketball season get here. But side team for football, I like the Seahawks, so I like watching their game. But another team I like to watch, especially after last year, I really want them to go back to the Super Bowl. I want them to get to the point where they go back to playing the rematch.
New Orleans Saints.
Nothing.
Who?
Because the New Orleans Saints got kicked out, and then it was the Rams and the.
But they
Kansas
should have
City.
Been. They shouldn't. They.
Okay.
It
okay.
seemed. It was like they really did good. I just knew they was gonna make it, and it was. I think if I'm not mistaken. You know how when the teams are playing and then they call stuff and they don't call stuff?
Yeah, so it was a bad call.
So I think that's how it went with the New Orleans Saints. The right calls were made I can't say which calls they were, but if the right calls had been made, they probably would have been in there because they was really coming out aggressive and they was playing good. So I really I really like that team.
And it wouldn't, I am from Louisiana, so it depends on what mood I'm in. But if the play would have went differently, then it probably would have been the Saints playing the Kansas City Chiefs. And then whoever would have won that would have played them day.
And I believe the Saints would have won. I ain't even playing. They wouldn't have played with that. I believe they would have won. Because all the games I watched, at least during the playoffs, those guys were playing they butt off. Like, they was not playing aggressively, offensive and defensive. They both sides, they were really playing. And it was like whoever played against them had to really bring it. So, when I think back to the Rams game when they played the Chiefs or whatever, it didn't seem like that type of game. But I'm telling you, if it was the Saints, I think they would have brought it if they had that opportunity.
So we'll see if it's going to come down to the Rams and the Saints getting to playing the game that they need to play to get to the Super Bowl. So we're going to see if the Saints and the Rams play or if the Kansas City. But I'm going back to Kansas City because it ended up being Kansas City and the Rams, and then the Rams lost, and then it ended up being Kansas City and the Patriots in the Super Bowl. So what I'm saying is I would like to see the Rams and the Kansas City Chiefs play a rematch so they can get to the next Super Bowl. And I don't have a problem with the Saints if they get there. So that's the teams to watch. The Saints, the Rams, and the Kansas City Chiefs. And we'll see what happens. But I don't know. They're talking about Dallas. They're talking about on the news today. Dallas got a team, and they're going to be the team to beat. So we will see. Okay, moving on.
We will see.
Okay, moving on. Because time is going. Moving on. We want to pray for Kevin Hart. For you guys that don't know, he was in a car accident, a very bad car accident. He had to end up having back surgery. He was not the only one in the car. He was not driving. He was a passenger, and he was in a car with 2 other people who were his friends, and he was in one of his vintage cars that he had just bought. The story says that he was able to find his way home from the accident. So I guess he went to the hospital from there. But I'm like, why did he even go to his house? Why he just didn't call whatever?
He probably was delirious.
Yeah, they say he was incoherent. So he didn't even realize he was in an accident. So he was, but thank God he was able to at least get to his house before he was able to get medical attention, because he did have to have back surgery. So as far as I know, he's still in the hospital. So we're praying for him that his life was spared, and he's, you know, he's going to be praying for recovery. So also, we also want to send out a prayer for the victims and that were affected by Hurricane Dorian this week. The victims in Bahamas, according to the news, Bahamas was hit very, very hard. So they're going to have to do a lot of rebuilding in the Bahamas. And then there are people affected in South Carolina as well. So if you want to give a donation, please go to www.redcross.org. And when you go to that page, you will be able to either mail the donation in, text the donation in, and make a phone call. So go to that website if you want to donate. It would be greatly appreciated. Now, let's get into the topic of our show. So I'll start it, Vicki, and then you can join me in the conversation. So me and Vicki are besties, sisters for life, you know, different mothers. How does it go? Same mother, different fathers, however that go. Y'all get the point.
So, mother from sister from another mother.
There we go. Thank you, Vicki. There we go. And really, on a serious note, we really feel that our relationship was ordained by God, because from the time we met, and we've been kicking it ever since. So anyway, when we try to have sister time together, so we do different things, but the things that we really enjoy doing together, and this is what we call sister time, is when we get to go to the movies. Or we watch shows together and we talk about it. So we were planning on going to the movies this week, but I'm moving because I'm having remodeling in my house, so we wasn't able to go to the movies physically, so we ended up watching movies on TV. So we ended up watching, believe it or not, Equalizer 2 on Starz Cable. Yes, I'm on the late break. I did not get to see Equalizer 2 in the movies, but I did see Equalizer 1 in the movies. Just a side note, we found out, so we're going to start doing that now. Tuesdays, if y'all didn't know, y'all can go to the movies on Tuesdays for cheap. So save your money and go on Tuesday. So you can go to Cinemark for $5.50 on Tuesdays, all day. Did you hear me? All day, $5.50. AMC members, you have to be an AMC stub member. And if you're an AMC stub member, you can sign up online or sign up when you get to the movies. If you're a member, you only pay $5. So Dika is a member. All righty then. So anyway, so as I was saying, we watched Equalizer 2. Go ahead.
Well, what I was going to say was, when we watch movies, whatever we watch, it's like we actually discuss the film. And we discuss what we got out of it. And usually it's focused on social issues of whatever issue that movie is addressing. We always discuss it. And then we end up coming up with something to help us even with what we do in the community. But a lot of times when we watch movies, that's what we do, whether it's at the movie theater or at home in the privacy of our own homes. Input I wanted to give on that.
And we have like 5 minutes left, so I want to be quick. But what else do we do at the movies that not everybody do, Vicki? When we go to the movies, what do we do?
We buy popcorn.
No. Okay, she forgot. We go to the movies, we stay all the way to the end, and we watch the
movie. Oh, yeah.
And
I forgot about that part. we don't get up and leave. Because I used to do that years ago, but we stopped doing since we've been going, I know. We stay, and that's part of because of how we do documentaries and we do shorts and all those things and promos or whatever. It's like we enjoy watching the credits. And also I do it when I watch superhero movies, because with superhero movies, when you stay and watch it all the way to the credits, they have clues that they pop up, that different, they have a scene with a clue. Sometimes it's more than one scene. It could be like two scenes, but it's sporadic. So they'll have like all these credits, then the scene will come up, and it'll be a clue on the next superhero movie that's going to come on after that one, like that they're going to make, or it's going to come out after that one. And then they'll fool around and do a whole nother clue. But it's like in between each clue, they have all these credits. So usually when it happened, it'd be like us in the theater with maybe two people out of all those people that was in the theater at first. But, yeah, but we do that for all movies that we watch.
And you made me think about it. We got to show you. One time we went to a movie, and we waited till the very end, and the lights was out and everything, and then they as Vicky tells me to get up, you know, before I got up, we saw a lady. She wasn't trying to move either. She was straight up in there smoking like nothing. Like she was a thug.
Yeah.
I'm like, she ain't supposed to be smoking up in here.
And I was like, you better be quiet. We don't know what she's doing. Thinking about even recording her or something, or take a picture. I was like, you better not.
Okay.
So we gotta I don't know if we have time to share much more, but I just wanted to give a stop in the middle. If we have time to go back and talk about some things, we can, but I just wanted to give a shout out to our sponsor, WEXP 88.3 sponsors us, as well as Eon H2O water. Eon H2O water sponsors us as well. They're basically all in, well, anyway, yeah. So they sponsor us, and we just want to let you know that we appreciate you. We appreciate your sacrifices and how you made a way for different hosts, different people to have a host show. And we just want to give her love and appreciate them for what they have, the platform that they have given us and other radio hosts that come on the podcast. Yeah. And then DJ Dika, can you go ahead and give them how they can reach us? And we want to tell our listeners, we appreciate you too. Whether you listen live or you listen at your leisure, we still appreciate you, because we're not just talking to ourselves. We're trying to speak to whoever ears is meant to hear what we're saying. And then, you know, and hoping that, you know, we are helping make your life much better, or help you to figure out how to make it better. So anyway, go ahead and do your media stuff, because we're getting close.
There you go, telling our business, talking about we not talking to ourselves. Yes, we do. Come on now. Man, you're going to tell our business again. Not for real. Okay, anyway, Divine Victory Ministries, if you want to teach us, we are available through social media, Divine Victory Ministries. Remember to click on the one that has the key in the middle. Oh, my God, I can't tell you what happened this week. We'll have to set up for next week. Somebody hit us up. Okay, anyway, Divine Victory Ministries with the key in the middle, Twitter, DVM418, Instagram, Divine Victory Ministries, small letters. Our email is divinevictoryproductions@gmail.com. Our website is divinevictoryministries.com. If you want to donate, you're welcome to donate. Press that little donate money button, excuse me, and we will take anything you want to give. We will not turn down nothing, okay? And on that note, we want to give you an encouragement. Last week, Coco, the tennis player, and Naomi, they played and Naomi ended up winning, and Coco is hot. She, you know, man, she hot. She's going to be doing some things. She's only 15 mm-hmm. years old, and Naomi is 21 years old. And even though Naomi won, she went to go comfort Coco, and she was
emotionally. We're going off the air, y'all. We only have 30-minute show. Much love. Peace.
Hallelujah. Holla back. Bye-bye.